Yeah, first of all, I'd like to thank the organizers of this conference. This is my first time visit Moscow. Well, I always have a great respect on Russian mathematics and science, partly because my advisor was Russian. And when even I was in high school, I learned about that time Sakharov and Solzhenitsyn. Anyway, when I decided to study mathematics, I learned a lot from Shaparevich and also Loglin. So I always wanted to visit Moscow, kind of center of Russian mathematics. But so anyway, I'm quite impressed by the quite heavy schedule of the conference, and also quite nice cookies and tea time. Every time we enjoy meal. Okay. My talk is a little bit kind of digress from the theme of this conference, birational geometry and Kerr-Einstein metrics. But somehow, sometimes you enjoy digress. Yeah? Okay, so let me go on. So my title is Fake Project Planes, and I'll report recent progress on this subject. Okay, here is my outline of my talk: fake project planes, Bloch conjecture, exceptional collections, and vanishing theorem, and bicanonical map, and explicit equations, and arithmetic quotient of the complex two-ball with minimum possible Chern numbers. Okay, here is the definition. Let me recall. A compact complex surface with the same Betti numbers as P2, then you see immediately first Betti number is 0, second Betti number 1, third Betti number 0. So topological Euler characteristic is 3, and first Betti number 0, so irregularity 0, and second Betti number 1, so geometric genus must be 0. So by Nesser formula, k square equal 9. And furthermore, this rank 1 lattice, means cohomology lattice, this is unimodular by Poincaré duality, and also positive definite. This follow from index theorem. So there is some non-trivial theorem involved. But anyway, so this is positive definite, so the surface must be algebraic. So the canonical class ample or negative ample, we have a dichotomy. So in the former case, we have P2, and the latter case, so-called fake projective plane. So fake projective plane can be defined as a compact complex surface with the same Betti numbers as P2, but not isomorphic, not biholomorphic to P2. A fake project plane has ample canonical divisor, so it is a smooth, geometrically connected proper surface of general type with PG0 and k square equal 9. So, and this definition is independent of characteristic. So this definition extends to arbitrary characteristic. So the existence of a FPP was first proved by Mumford based on the theory of two-adic uniformization, but this is very abstract. And then Ishida and Gatto proved existence of two more in this abstract method. And then quite recently, Orcog and Gatto added one more, but from a lattice with torsion. And myself, 2006, gave a construction of FPP, AJ Galois cover of a singular model of Ishida elliptic surface. This is elliptic surface simply connected with two multiple fibers, multiplicity 2 and 3, and which is covered non-Galois by Mumford fake project plan. Actually, this elliptic surface was studied by Ishida to understand, in his try to understanding Mumford fake project plane. So the fundamental group Mumford fake project plane can be contained in a maximal arithmetic subgroup. And this Ishida surface is nothing but the quotient of complex two-ball by this maximal arithmetic subgroup. But of course, it has some singularities. So you resolve the singularities, this simple quotient singularities, order 3 and 7, then you get a minimal elliptic surface with Godard dimension 1. And then I noticed that you can get Galois cover. So my surface is Galois cover of this, but Mumford surface is not. So Mumford surface has no automorphism group, no automorphism, but my surface has order, the automorphism group of order 21. Okay, fake project planes have Chern numbers, C1 square equals 3C2 equal. So this is a Miyaoka-Yau line. So hence, admit Carroll-Einstein matrix of constant curvature. Hence, complex two-ball quotient. So in dimension 1, every Riemann surface of genus bigger than 1 is a ball quotient. But in surface case, in higher dimensional case, it's very rare. So very, very special class can be ball quotient. Such ball quotients are strongly rigid by rigidity theorem of Mostow. And thus, in particular, so this determined by fundamental group, by its fundamental group up to plus minus holomorphic or anti-holomorphic isomorphism. And for fake project plane case, Kharlamov and Kulikov proved that the complex conjugate of given fake project plane never be biholomorphic to the given fake project plane. So fake project planes come in complex conjugate pairs. So their fundamental groups are arithmetic. So this is also non-trivial part. So fake project plane is nothing but a kind of Shimura varieties. And their fundamental groups are classified and enumerated by explicit co-compact torsion-free arithmetic subgroup, or PU21, by Prasad and Jung and Cartwright and Steger. Actually, these two are group theorists and also expert on computer. So they carried out all this explicit computation. Of course, so this arithmeticity, but already the all maximal arithmetic subgroups of PU21 was already listed by Prasad and his collaborator. So the problem is just check which subgroup of each maximal arithmetic subgroup do satisfy these kind of conditions. Kind of Euler number should be 3. And the first Betti number should be 0. So abelianization of the fundamental group is finite. So the result is quite surprising. There are exactly 100 fake project planes in total, and 50 distinct fundamental groups. Oh. So, but here, let me list interesting problems on fake project planes. So exceptional collections, a bicanonical map, explicit equations, and Bloch conjecture, arithmetic quotient. Well, Still, all these topics are not solved yet. So I will go over how much we know on these topics. For a smooth projective variety X, the group of, okay, this is Bloch conjecture. Oh, the title is up there. The group of zero cycles modulo rational equivalence is denoted by A0 of X. Then the degree map, then the Bloch conjecture that for any smooth projective surface with PG0, the kernel of this map is zero. In other words, the degree map is isomorphic, gives isomorphic isomorphism between A0 of X and yeah. And this is a theorem for non-general type surfaces, but general type case, this is confirmed for several known examples of surface of general type with PG0, but not confirmed for any FPP. Here is a remark, but if PG equal non, PG is not zero, then it's very, strikingly different situation. In this case, A0 of X is infinite dimensional. So the symmetric power of the surface maps to A0 of X is never surjective for any M. Okay, so let's go back. Move to the derived categories. So it is quite well known at Pn, then it's a bounded derived category, bounded complexes of and then this is kind of can be there is an exceptional sequence which generate this category. The length is exactly same as Euler number. And so, and then this Galkin, Kacharkov, Mellit, Schindler, they conjecture that because fake projective plane also has second bit Euler number 3, and there is an ample line bundle L with L square equal 1 such that OX minus L minus 2L for an exceptional sequence or maximum length 3. And also this conjecture not yet proved general, but has been confirmed for up to now, up to now 9 pairs of FPPs. So this three is fake projective planes with the automorphism group order 21, and this is order 9. And these are no automorphism, but this one includes Mumford fake project plane. So this last three, it's done by Fakhruddin. And also, some FPPs may have two distinct exceptional sequences, but this happens very rarely. So only I found one in this case, and also one in this case. Right, OX and something else, L prime, and yeah, 2L prime. The derived category of bounded complexes with coherent sheaves on a smooth variety W. Let me just brief review. And an object is exceptional if this harm from E to E shifted I is equal to zero, is C only for I equal zero, and zero otherwise. And a sequence exception of exceptional object is an exceptional sequence if this condition holds for any j is bigger than k and for any I. When W is a smooth surface with P equal Q equal zero, every line bundle is an exceptional object. So for example, F is a fake project plane, L, ample line bundle with L square equal one, then 2LLOX or OX minus L minus 2L from an exceptional sequence if and only if this vanishing holds. If and only if essentially the vanishing, so 2L is not effective. And also K minus L is not effective. So, and you can think of the complement, semi-orthogonal complement of the Dmitry-Smil triangulated subcategory generated by these three objects. Then in this case, fake project plane is not simply connected. So fundamental group is infinite. So in particular, A is non-zero. Let me skip maybe this part. Okay, so this is also related to Bloch conjecture. So for example, if Bloch conjecture holds for X, in other words, if second Chow group is infinite cyclic, then this Grothendieck group K0 of the semi-orthogonal complement is finite. Okay, so always subtitle is hidden on top. Okay, let me recall the Picard group of any fake project plane is isomorphic to second cohomology group, integral cohomology group. This is rank one plus torsions. Always this torsion is non-zero. And this torsion part is nothing but torsion of H1, but H1 is finite, so it is equal to first integral homology group. So the free part is a unimodular lattice of rank one. If M and M prime both ample with same self-intersection, then both must be square number. Then the difference must be a torsion line bundle because we have only one. This is rank one, so we have you take just any ample generator, and then any other choice of ample generator, the difference is just the torsion line bundle. So for any ample line bundle M, M square is a square integer, as I said, and when M square is at least 9, then M is effective if and only if M is not canonical divisor or canonical line bundle. This follows from the Riemann-Roch and Godaira vanishing. But when M square is at most 4, then this one may not vanish, though no example of non-vanishing. I don't know any example of non-vanishing for any fake project plane and any line bundle with self-intersection 1 or 4. So here, let X be FPP with the largest possible. Let me say, Cartwright and Steger, they also computed all possible, all automorphism groups. This is nothing but the quotient group of normalization of fundamental group inside the maximal arithmetic subgroup by the fundamental group. So we have four choices, order 21. This is a unique non-abelian group of order 21. And another one is the C3 square. And the third one is the C3, and the last one is trivial one. Then for every C7 invariant ample line bundle M with M square equal 4, we have this vanishing. So in particular, for each line bundle L with L square equal 0, L square equal 1, then we have this vanishing. So this was stated in my paper 2017, but there I put only only M equal 2L this case, but the proof uses only the invariance of this line bundle. And Cartwright Stegger, a fake project plane with this order 21 automorphism group, has only two torsions. So this eight to torsion, I mean, the torsion group is two elementary, all two elementary. Thus, Kx has unique cube roots because this one doesn't have any three torsion. So Picard group doesn't have any three torsion. So canonical class should have a unique cube root. Otherwise, 3 times L0 is equal to Kx. If M is ample with M square equal small m square, then M should be linearly equivalent to small m times L0 plus some torsion, should be a 2 torsion. Hence, 2m should be linearly equivalent to 2m L0. And this must be invariant on every automorphism. So if m is equal to 2 times L0 plus t, it's invariant under an automorphism. If and only if, so is this 2 torsion, because L0 is always invariant under any automorphism. And recent work by myself and Fabrizio Catanese, the C3 action on H1 fixes no two torsion element in these two cases, and only one in the case here. So, for example, only in this case, these two torsion, if you twist L by these two torsion, you get another exceptional sequence. So similarly, in this case, automorphism group is C3 square, so we get a similar result. But in this case, not only two torsion, this is 14, 7, and this is C2 square times C13. But anyway, so we get a similar result here. Also in this case, only one fake project plane, I mean one pair of fake project plane, there is a non-trivial two torsion, which is automorphism group invariant. And for this two torsion, again, you can get distinct exceptional sequence. So this vanishing guarantees the OX and minus L0 and minus 2 L0 gives a exceptional sequence. So in both proofs, we use the structure of the quotient for energy. The key idea of proof is that kind of if the dimension is bigger than or equal to 4, then I mean if this is effective, otherwise this H0 is non-zero, then the 2m will have linear dimension at least 4. But this one contradicts Riemann-Roch. So here's the corollary. If you have a fake project plane with automorphism group over the 21 or 9, let L0 be the unique cube root of Kx, then the 3 line bundles form an exceptional sequence on X. If T is a C7 or C3 square invariant torsion line bundle, then the 3 line bundles form another exceptional sequence. Well, as I said before, I mean, this is equivalent to vanishing of cohomologies. Essentially, this is equivalent to vanishing of global sections. Okay, so this is all I know about exceptional sequences. And now let's go back, turn to the issue on bicanonical map. A projective surface with PG equal 0 has no canonical map because canonical system is empty. Oh, it's disappeared. And then applying a Rader's theorem on adjoint linear systems on when his theorem is for any surface of general type. And this adjoint system, Kx plus M, is very ample for any net line bundle M with M square is bigger than 9. So if you take Kx and if you take any M bigger than Kx numerically, and then this one is always very ample. In other words, if you take any linear divisor which is bigger than 2kx, it always gives you a very ample system. So for example, if m square equals 16, then this one gives an embedding into P14. If take m is equal to kx, then by radar again, this adjoint system is base point free. So it defines a map, and this is an embedding away from finite number of points. So on certain point, it may fail to be an embedding. And this map is the normalization map of the image. And up to now, we checked that only 10 pairs of fake project planes, this map gives an embedding. So a priori, I mean, in principle, no. So still, this conjecture holds true, but we have proof for only for 10 pairs out of 50.
Birational?
Yes, birational, and only kind of few points. Yeah, it's something like this. It's 2 points. There is a curve. So radar theorem says if 2 points are not separated, then there must be some simple curve. In our case, this is one, and then this one maps by two, something like this. This 2 point goes to one. And also, this is also possible. Infinitely near points can go to like, so this is highly non-normal, yeah? The image are not normal surface. So this, I said here, the bicanonical map in this case is a normalization map of the image. It's birational. So away from, so this is one-to-one and embedding away from only finite number of points. And these points, so here, the bicanonical map may fail to be an embedding only on a curve C with C square equal 1 by radar theorem here, I explained. So if there is no such curve on the surface, then we are done. So this is nothing but the line bundle with self-intersection 1. So let X be of FPP if H0 L equal 0 for all ample line bundle L with L square equal 1, then the bicanonical map is an embedding. So this vanishing we proved for 9 pairs of FPPs. So 3 pairs, this is all, and 2 pairs, so missing 1. Actually, there are 3 such pairs, and the 4 pairs with automorphism C3. And among the 3 pairs here, the missing one, this missing one has H1 C14. But for this pair, we do not prove the vanishing, but still able to prove the very ampleness by geometric argument. Well, now we go to equations. Well, it has long been of great interest since Mumford to find, how much time do I have? Okay, 30 minutes, good. Find equations of an FPP. Recently, with Borisov, we find equations of a conjugate pair of fake project planes by using the geometry of the quotient of such FPP, which I studied, I classified possible structures. You know that the fake project plane is Picard number 1, and also it doesn't contain a small genus curve. So this is difficulty. Usually you do geometry, if you have lines or conics on your subject, then you can cook some useful linear system using these curves, and then, but fake project plane is very difficult to see such curve. I mean, no such curve. For example, even LSK equal 1 or LSK equal 4, they may not exist such curves. So very kind of high arithmetic genus curves exist. But on the quotient, sometimes, for example, order 7 quotient, they are elliptic surface, so elliptic fibration structure, and reducible fiber. So you will see many rational curves, minus 2 curves there. So you see some curves which you cannot see upstairs. So this is the this was the idea, and then the equations, our final result, the equations are given explicitly as 84 cubic equations in P9 with coefficient in the quadratic extension, the number field, and also conjugating equations, conjugating the coefficients, we get the complex conjugate of the surface. This pair has the most geometric symmetries among the 50 pairs, in the sense that its automorphism group has order 21, the largest possible order. Well, some people call such fake project planes and Coombs fake project planes. The C7 quotient, in this case, C7 quotient, C7 is a unique normal subgroup. C7 quotient has a smooth model of 2-4 elliptic surface. But this is not simply connected. So again, so this one is a fundamental group order 2. So you can take the universal double cover. Then this will give you another elliptic surface. So this gives you more structure. So you will see. So this is not simply connected. So it's a fundamental group C2. And the universal double cover of this elliptic surface has only one multiple fiber with multiplicity 2. So actually this double fiber becomes non-double fiber, and this one becomes multiplicity 2 fiber upstairs. So you have elliptic fibration with only one double fiber. But this one has, we can show that has same Hodge numbers as K3. But it has double fiber, so it is not K3. So canonical class is half of this fiber. But Godard dimension 1. And also, we can show that this one has two I9 fibers. One nine, I should say, in Godard notation. And many triple sections. So here are equations. I cannot show all of them. Yes. Yeah.
There are 84 independent equations versus facing.
Well, certainly they are, I mean, you know, you can throw many of them. I mean, in principle, any surface in P9 can be cut out by 10 equations. Okay, this is general. Any surface in P9 can be cut out scheme theoretically. And also, you can to define, I mean, maybe some proper subset of these equations may define the same variety. And a colleague, I mean, a mathematician who told me that he checked that 15, carefully chosen 15 equations define the same surface. Maybe you cannot reduce to number 10. This case. And also some equations are symmetric with respect to the automorphism. G3 is order 3 automorphism. And here we choose, I mean, from the construction, from the argument, okay, we can kind of normalize the action of this order 7 and order 3. So this order 21 representation has three one-dimensional representation and two three-dimensional representations. So here, the trivial representation, first coordinate, and this is a three-dimensional representation. The order 3 rotating coordinate, and then this order 7, and the diagonally acting. So here, so this first one is a complex conjugate of the representation of second and third. And this here, zeta is seventh root of unity. So, well, after we got these equations, well, how we got this equation? Here. So on this double cover, we were able to find a suitable divisor using this the various minus two curves and sections, which gives you an embedding into P3, bidirectional embedding. So let me put this right. So our FPP, and then you take minimal resolution. This is a 2-4 elliptic surface. And then we take double cover, universal cover. It's no good. And then on here, we can find a suitable divisor. Gives a morphism into P3. This is birational onto a sextet surface, a single equation, but highly non-normal. And also we see various curves here, many minus two curves and minus three curves, which are the double sections. And then their image here. So some of them goes to lines, some of them goes to conics, and so on. So using all this information, we can get this equation. This is explicit equation. So from this equation, somehow we can get the equation of y, equations of y. And then this is a 7-to-1 cover. So eventually we get the equations of y, equations of a given fake project plane. So this is nothing but just you're taking a cyclic curve means that you introduce a new coordinate. And then the which is branched along. We know also the branch divisors downstairs. So all this computation can be done. Okay, so and then after we got these equations, and then we need to double check. So the computer gives us equations. Then how? So we need to check. And it can be verified that the variety defined by the 84 equations is indeed a FPP. How we check here? We use magma or Macaulay 2. So we do not have any specific preference of this. We just try one, and it works okay. Otherwise, we try another, so on. So sometimes this one is more effective. Some calculation, this one is more effective. And then magma calculate the Hilbert series of jet. You just type in all these 84 equations, and then hit the key, and then it gives you Hilbert polynomial. It's already quadratic, meaning that this is a surface. And smoothness of jet is a subtle problem. So this is 84 equations. So if you do the Jacobian matrix of this 84, this is what? We have 10 variables, so 10 times 84 linear equations. So, and then computer that, I mean, wouldn't answer anything. So we need to somehow modify our computation. But anyway, so this, during our computation, we choose a suitable prime, 263. So also there is no specific reason why we choose 263, but you can try some other prime, of course. So this is a reasonable size prime, not too complicated, but not too small, so that not degenerate the coefficient. Such that this prime has a clear square root of negative 7, so this is 16. And this is 84 times 10 Jacobian matrix has too many 7 by 7 minus. So by adding suitably chosen 3 minus to the ideal, so given ideal, plus this 7 by 7 minus, generate unit ideal, then this surface must be smooth. Okay? There is no common root. But we choose, this 84 equation, the ideal, and then we add suitably chosen 3 minus to the ideal. And then the Hilbert polynomial drops from this quadratic to linear by adding one, and then adding another, and then constant, adding third in zero. So Hilbert polynomial zero means the ideal of this 84 cubic equations and this 7 by 7 minus generate unit ideal eventually. So there is no root, no common zero. So this means the variety, the surface jet is smooth. If the equations generate the ring modulo 263, then they also generate it with exact coefficient. So Z is a smooth surface with a very ample divisor class. And from the Hilbert polynomial, we see that d square equals 36 and dkz is 18. And Euler characteristic of structure shift is equal to 1. So in particular, this shows that z is connected. And in particular, z is not holomorphic, biholomorphic isomorphic to P2 because canonical class is effective. And also Macaulay 2 calculate over the same finite field the projective resolution of structure shift this way. Well, here I said you can reduce the number of equations, but in practice, when you want to compute this kind of projective resolution, we need essentially the saturated ideal. We need all equations. So surprisingly, here all these numbers are less than 9, less than 10, see? They are acyclic. So this is acyclic and this is acyclic, so the image is acyclic. I mean, all cohomologies vanish. So the kernel is acyclic and this is acyclic, and so the image is acyclic and so on, keep going. So the image is the ideal here, this 84 cubic. So this is acyclic. So the cohomology of O, and this O means O of P9, cohomology of O and cohomology of OZ are identical. So by semi-continuity, I mean up to certain degree, then the resolution is of the same shape over C, since all the shapes are cyclic, I mean, because all these numbers less than 10, or bigger than minus 10, we see that this cohomology group is equal to this cohomology group. In particular, H1 of Z, H2 of Z, both zero, H0 of Z is equal to 1. So irregularity zero and geometric genus zero. And also, Macaulay 2 also calculate, also you can try with magma. this case. Again, working with modulo 263, and then bicanonical line bundle, the Euler this characteristic is equal to 10. So this implies that k squared equal to 9. So that is a fake project plane. Here we calculated this, even this kind of things all compute. I mean, now computational algebra or commutative algebra people, they develop all this kind of package. Now so you just hit key, correct key, and then it will immediately gives you. But here, also by working modulo 263 and semi-continuity, this implies that H0 of D minus K is equal to 0. This is nothing but H2 of 2K minus D. So by Riemann-Roch, then this implies that H0 of 2K minus D is at least 1. In other words, this is effective. 2K minus D is effective, but they are numerically equivalent, so they must be isomorphic line bundles. So this fake project plane, Z, is embedded by bicanonical embedding. So as I said before, we proved that for this pair of fake project plane, we proved bicanonical map gives an embedding. But in our computation of these equations, we did not assume this. We did not use this. But so these equations give explicit proof for this embeddability. I mean, very ampleness of bicanonical system. And that can be further identified with FPP, which we started with. How we check, indeed, this hyperplane cut out a double curve, say, to B, and this B is can check the C7 invariant curve with B squared equal 9, and 2B is equal to 2KZ. So B must be KZ plus some non-trivial torsion. So this property characterizes among the three FPPs with order 21 automorphism group. So D1 with this one. So exactly we can check everything. We get the surface from the beginning. So our surface is degree 36 surface in P9, defined by 84, but you can reduce the number. So far I know it's about 15 is you know more than enough. Okay, so let me finish my talk with final remark. I still have 10 minutes. It's arithmetic quotient of the complex two-ball with minimum possible turn numbers. So next one is 18 and then 27 and so on. And Cartwright and Steger computed all of them. So there are 101 total. So 100 fake project planes. There are 50 pairs of complex conjugate. And as a byproduct of their computation, they found another interesting surface, so-called Cartwright-Steger surface. This is the unique arithmetic quotient with PG equal Q equal 1, and C1 square equal 3, C2 is equal to 9. Actually, one can show that if you have this kind of condition, and then this one is at most 2. So this is this can be a proven geometric argument. So this is kind of a arithmetic, classification of arithmetic quotient of complex two-ball with this condition. Here's the question. So is a surface of general type with this condition always an arithmetic quotient of the complex two-ball? So this is open. In other words, there is a non-arithmetic quotient of the complex two-ball with this. Okay, let me stop here. Yeah, in many cases, yeah. If you choose suitably, suitable prime.
Large enough.
Yeah,
right?
yeah.
But for small enough, I mean,
of course, I mean.
Your plane, right?
Yeah, and also other plane. Yeah. Our case, the fundamental group is also defined over the same number field, Q square root negative 7. But this is a coincidence. So it's not necessarily. And also Cartwright-Steger classification, they computed fundamental groups over explicitly given number field. And then so maybe if this group is has good reduction mod P, then it will give you fake project plane in that positive characteristic. And let me remark one. So of course, in positive characteristics, there are also fake project planes. And let me remark in characteristic three, Ekedal, long time ago, he constructed infinitely many fake project planes, positive dimensional family. Over complex number field, we have only 100 points. Modular space consists of only 100 points, but.
And it's only characteristic
three. Yeah, so small characteristics, of course, you can have some pathology or plenty of enjoyment, but in big characteristics, I think that the situation is quite similar. Yes, smooth surface. So it's also quotient of two ball by an arithmetic subgroup which acts freely on the two ball. Ishida quotient is non-smooth, so some element has fixed point, so that gives you some singularity. So.
Okay.
Thank you.